Five people you wouldn't believe exist. A lot of people would consider their lives ordinary, waking up in the morning and going to school or work to then come home and relax with their family or go out with their friends. Unfortunately for some, that ordinary lifestyle is only a dream as they are forced to live extraordinary lives. Here is our list of the top five people you wouldn't believe existed. Number five, Didier Montalvo, Turtle Boy. Didier Montalvo, aka Turtle Boy, was born in Colombia with congenital melancytic nevus, which causes a large growth otherwise known as a mole to grow on his back. This mole grew to cover his entire back and formed what looked like a turtle shell, which is where the name Turtle Boy derived from. Unfortunately for Didier, the growth didn't only affect his confidence, but was also painfully itchy. It also caused problems from his village, as they ostracized him and his mother as they believed Didier was touched by evil forces. Thankfully, Didier had undergone life-changing surgery to remove the mole 3 years ago and has been recovering and making a new life ever since. Number four, Elaine Davidson, Most Pierced Woman. If you think getting your ears or tongue pierced is a difficult decision, then you'll be amazed by Elaine Davidson. Elaine was born in Brazil but now resides in Edinburgh, Scotland, and has been in the spotlight for the most piercings since May 2000, where she has been increasingly adding more piercings to her bodied collection. Elaine had entered the Guinness World Records in May 2000 with a total of 462 piercings, 192 of those piercings being on her face alone. Over the years, Elaine has continued to add to her collection, and the latest report on June 8, 2011, when she became married, she had tallied a total of 6,925 piercings internally and externally attached to her body. All these piercings added up to a combined weight of 3 kilograms. Elaine hasn't had any updated reports since her marriage, but we assume that she has probably broken that 7,000 piercings mark by now. Number three, Claudia Vieira de Oliveira, Upside Down Head Man. Claudia Vieira de Oliveira in Monsanto, Brazil, was born majorly deformed due to a condition he has called arthrogryposis. People born with this condition have their joints fused together and are born extremely deformed. When Claudio was born, the doctors had advised his mother to starve him to death as he was so badly deformed. Thankfully, she went against their advice and Claudio still lives to this day. His joints have fused together and contorted Claudio's head backwards and upside down, giving him the nickname of Upside Down Head Man. He couldn't stand or walk, and he had to be carried everywhere until he was 8 years old when he discovered he could walk on his knees. Claudio never gave up on doing what he wanted. He learned at a very young age how to type with a pen and use his lips to operate a phone and computer mouse, making himself as resourceful as he could with his disability. Against all the odds, Claudio went to study in university to become a qualified accountant and even wrote and published his own book called El Mundo Está a Contramano, The World is the Wrong Way Around. He has also been invited to be a public speaker traveling around the world. It's easy to see that Claudio is truly inspiring and represents the motto of never giving up, and we wish him all the best for it. Like our list so far? Why not support us by subscribing and liking this video? We would really appreciate it. Number two, Beth Goodyear, Sleeping Beauty Syndrome, KLS. We have all heard the tales of Sleeping Beauty, but what if Sleeping Beauty was a reality? Well, for someone like Beth Goodyear, it is a very real reality. Beth Goodyear is from Stockport, Greater Manchester, UK, and suffers from a neurological condition named Klein-Levin Syndrome, or KLS for short, and was nicknamed the Sleeping Beauty Syndrome. Sleeping Beauty Syndrome comes in waves of exhaustion, and for someone like Beth, that means 22 hours of sleeping per day, and these episodes can last up to 5 weeks. Unfortunately, there is no cure for KLS, meaning people who suffer from this condition have to live with its resulting in putting lives on hold. Beth reportedly started college 4 times and had to drop out each time due to her uncontrollable condition. She had to watch her friends go through their A levels and move away to university whilst she stayed home and slept. KLS only affects around 1,000 people worldwide, and with limited understanding of what causes KLS and how to cure it, it looks like there won't be a cure for some time. Number one, Fatima Ghazawi, allergic to sunlight. We all enjoy those holidays away, standing in the sunlight with the beach breeze flowing through your hair and the sun tanning your skin to a darker tone. Pure bliss, right? Fatima Gazoue from Maha Media Morocco would disagree. Fatima suffers from a rare skin condition known as exerderma pigmentosum, or XP for short, which results in the UV rays from the sun damaging her skin. Fatima cannot leave her home without a special mask being worn and be fully clothed to stop UV light from touching her skin. Having avoided direct sunlight contact for over 20 years, Fatima typically begins her day at nightfall, where she goes out with having to worry about the UV rays from the sun. With XP, Fatima's skin becomes freckled and easily sunburnt with signs of dry skin and skin aging. Fatima has since strived to spread awareness of her disease by joining the Association of Solidarity with Children of the Moon, which focuses on helping people living with XP. So we come to the end of our list. What do you think? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to be notified of our next video. Thanks for watching.